Once upon a time in the ancient world. Most stories begin with once upon a time, but I guarantee you, this is no fairy tale. It begins in the city of Thebes in ancient Greece, which was modeled after the Thebes in Egypt. The king and queen of Thebes were expecting a child, and they were very happy. However, one day, one of the oracle wizard-type people delivered a prophecy unto the king that said his child would one day murder him. So, of course, thinking logically, the king did what any good father would do. He gave his newborn child to one of his servants, drove spikes into his feet so he could never come home, and ordered him to be tossed into the river. Fortunately, the servant wasn't a completely horrible human being, and instead of throwing the baby in the river, he decided just to leave it for dead on the mountain, which apparently wasn't quite as bad. And more fortunate still, a shepherd just happened to be passing by that very day, and discovered this poor baby all alone. He was from the town of Corinth, which was just across the mountain from Thebes. As it turns out, the king and queen of Corinth were unable to have children of their own, so as a gift, the shepherd gave this little boy to the king and queen. They were very happy, and they named him Oedipus, which literally means swollen foot. Little did they know, his life would be a tragedy. Over time, like all people, Oedipus grew up and became a strapping young man. One day he was out drinking with his friend when he discovered some troubling news.
Oedipus, I gotta tell you something, man. I mean, I love you like a brother, Oedipus, but you gotta tell you the truth. You're adopted, dude. You're adopted.
Oedipus.
Oedipus, of course, was shocked, and he had to know the truth himself. Oedipus traveled all the way from Corinth to Delphi, where he decided to visit the Temple of Apollo and ask the Oracle. Although she did not confirm or deny his adoption, she did deliver a familiar prophecy, which was that he would kill his own father. Only, of course, Oedipus believed his father was the king of Corinth, and had no idea about Thebes. Vowing never to return to Corinth to protect the man he believed was his father, he ended up on the road to Thebes. While he was walking along, enjoying the scenery, turns out there was a grumpy old man behind him who thought he was going a little bit too slow. So, as old men often do when they're annoyed, he decided to poke that youngin with his walking stick.
Hurry it up, youngin!
This made Oedipus very angry, and you would not like him when he's angry. With his companions defeated, the old man could only stand there and tremble in fear as Oedipus killed him with his bare hands. It was only after Oedipus calmed down that he realized, hey, I just killed some guys and an old man. One of the old man's companions, who was actually his servant, managed to escape the bloody massacre, though. Oedipus didn't realize it. Despite having killed some guys earlier that day, Oedipus continued to Thebes like it was no big deal. When Oedipus reached the outskirts of Thebes, he noticed something was up. Turns out there was a vicious creature guarding the gateway to the city, eating everyone alive. It had the body of a lion, wings of an eagle, and the breasts of a woman. It was the Sphinx. "Answer my riddle," she said, "and I will let you live." This is Life or Death Jeopardy! Your contestant today is Oedipus of Thebes, and your always lovely host, the Sphinx. Here's today's clue. This creature walks on four legs in the morning, two at noon, and three in the evening.
And you said...
What is a man? That's correct.
The Sphinx was so upset that Oedipus answered the riddle correctly that she did the only logical thing and hurled herself off a mountain. Oedipus was hailed as a hero in Thebes.
Because Thebes was without a king, Oedipus was immediately crowned as ruler of the city and even got to marry the queen. Does she look familiar? Because she should. Oh yeah, and they had 4 kids together. Nice. As the years went by, it became apparent that a plague had settled over the land, leaving their fields and women bare. Oedipus sent his brother-in-law Creon to the temple at Apollo to investigate. Creon soon returned and told the king that the only way to get rid of the plague was to find out who killed the former king of Thebes. Oedipus decided he would have to investigate, and so he began to ask around and he got the same answer from all the townspeople. He was to talk to the blind prophet, for he knew all. He approached the blind prophet, and he revealed some shocking news to Oedipus. He said,
"You are the killer, Oedipus. It was you that killed the former king."
This made Oedipus very angry, so he left. The blind prophet said,
"I might be blind to the world, Oedipus, but you are blind to the truth."
Oedipus rushed home to the queen to explain.
"That can't be true. You've never murdered anyone, have you?"
"Dear, it was years ago, before we were even married."
How did he look?"
Oedipus recalled the day that he killed the man and all of the men that were with him. The queen knew it had to be him.
"I am told there was a witness that day," Oedipus said. "I need to hear what he has to say." The queen had already put 2 and 2 together, though. When the witness arrived and revealed who he was, Oedipus was shocked. It was the man that had gotten away all those years ago. The only living, remaining servant of the king.
"'Twas you, Oedipus. 'Twas you who killed my king."
Oedipus was furious at his wife for not telling him the truth. Enraged, Oedipus rushed home to kill his wife. But he didn't have to. While Oedipus was out, the queen hung herself. It was then Oedipus made the most shocking revelation of all and put all the pieces together. He remembered the prophecy the oracle at the Temple of Apollo gave him long ago that said he would kill his own father. If the man that he had killed all those years ago on the road to Thebes was his father, and his father was the king, that meant his mom was the queen, and that he had married and conceived children with his own mother. Oedipus was so horrified by this revelation that he went into a panic, grabbed a nearby knife, and begin to gouge out his eyes. It would appear that Oedipus's destiny was inescapable. The ironic thing, of course, was like the blind prophet, now Oedipus was both blind to the world, but also the truth. As king of Thebes, Oedipus did the only right thing he could, and banished himself from the city. Oedipus left his sons behind in the city to rule in his place. They quarreled all the time and were eventually killed. Oedipus brought his 2 daughters with him into the wilderness. They were both eventually murdered. And one day in his old age, Oedipus was said to be struck by a lightning bolt, killing him instantly. However, the ancient Greeks say that to be struck by a lightning bolt means to be called up to Mount Olympus with Zeus himself. So maybe Oedipus is there, watching over the land of Thebes for eternity. And so ends the tale of Oedipus. Historically the first. Motherfucker.